name is Miles Gray. I would like to point out the opposition's opinion. We believe that none of the violence in the Egyptian Revolution was justified, whether it be civilian or military. I will prove how none of it is justified. First, the president, during the beginning of the revolution, Hosni Mubarak, actually resigned 18 days after the revolution began and was forced out by the military before any violent action was taken by the military or the Egyptians. The proposition claimed otherwise, where he was forced out through military force. He was threatened by the people's resistance and decided to resign instead of facing what could happen if he stayed. Unfortunately, once he resigned, the military took over and appointed Mohamed Morsi to lead the country. As a second rebuke, I would like to point out the statement made by the proposition that the military found itself as a protector of the revolution. It has been stated by CNN and other sources that once Morsi was in office, he considered the revolutionaries to be a terrorist group, giving the Egyptian police a quote-unquote reason to attack them. Although it is shown that Morsi instantly went to violence, it could have easily been avoided, and there is no justification for Morsi's actions. Morsi created acts of terror and death throughout his term, and once he was taken from office, he was accused and found guilty of inflicting deadly violence, all without good reason. Finally, during Morsi's time as president, an innocent Egyptian, Khalid Said, was shot by the government with no reason. A Google marketing executive was in Dubai browsing Facebook and found an image of the bloody remains of Said. He then decided to make a Facebook page entitled "We Are All Khalid Said," showing his sadness. It quickly rose in popularity, starting at 300 people in the first 2 minutes and jumping to 250,000 people after 3 months. He became an accidental activist and was able to organize and bring the few revolutionaries within that connection together and fuel the revolution. His activism has shown the inexplicable violence by the government at the point in the revolution and showing how unjust the government's means of fighting back have been, as well as being able to show the horrors in Egypt to the rest of the globe. In conclusion, it has been proven by this evidence that any violence from the government was not justifiable in the slightest, nor was the civilian violence, because it was shown that things got done without the need.